Friends, welcome to my history class. I am here with an illustrious ruler of medieval Assam. Yes, he is none other than Rudra Singha from the Ahom dynasty. First of all, let's have a glance on the history of Ahom rule in Assam.
From 1228 to 1826, Assam was ruled by the Ahom kings, who were altogether 39. They were the members of the Shan branch of Great Thai family of Southeast Asia. With the coming of the Ahoms, political power shifted from the western to the eastern part of the Brahmaputra Valley. In spite of occasional challenges, the Ahom rule lasted for 600 years. By the end of today's discussion, you will be able to know who was Rudra Singha, when did he come to power, where from he ruled his kingdom, what were his traits, how did he achieve success, and why is he called the greatest Ahom king. Rudra Singha was the 30th king of the Ahom dynasty. He was the son and successor of the Ahom king Gadadhar Singha. He belonged to the Tungkhungia clan. He is also known by his Ahom name Sukrangpa. Reign of Rudra Singha was for a period of 18 years, from 1696 to 1714. Capital of the Ahom kingdom during the rule of Rudra Singha was Gorgaon. Here is the Ahom territory in the 17th century. Koch kingdom, Jayantia kingdom, Kachari kingdom, and the Mughal empire were the neighboring powers of the Ahom kingdom. Challenges before Rudra Singha were: immediately after his accession, he reversed his father's intolerant policy towards the Vaishnava Gosais. He rehabilitated most of the displaced monks to their original satras. He was favoring the Brahmin satras. Immediately after his accession, Rudra Singha reversed his father's intolerant policy towards the Vaishnava Gosais. He rehabilitated most of the displaced monks to their original satras. He was favoring the Brahmin pontiffs. They were permitted to resume their position subject to the condition that their headquarters would be at Majuli. Rudra Singha received the satradhikar of Auniyati Satra as his religious preceptor. This recognition of spiritual superiority of the Gosai helped him to assert the supremacy of the king in other matters. Rudra Singha pursued a policy of divide and rule to reduce the power of the satradhikars. The most striking event of Rudra Singha were the wars against Kachari and the Jayantia kings. He subjugated the Kacharis and the Jayantias, who had become virtually independent during the period of the Mughal wars in the 17th century. As a means to enforce political and economic authority over the Jayantias, Rudra Singha imposed an economic blockade by closing the markets and passes to the Jayantias. Rudra Singha made efforts to establish diplomatic relations with the Raja of Tripura, and he was successful. He also established friendly commercial relations with the Khasi state. Rudra Singha had the ambition to extend the western frontier of his kingdom up to Bengal. He had two ends in view: to oust the Mughals from the sovereign power in eastern India and to expand the Ahom territory up to the Korotwa in the west. But his efforts went futile because of his death in 1714. Achievements of Rudra Singha in the field of architecture. Rudra Singha was eager to build a palace and city of brick, but there was none in his kingdom who knew how to do this. So he imported from Kuch Vihar an artisan under whose supervision numerous brick buildings were erected at Rangpur and Charaideo. The Karenghar, a seven-storied palatial building, was built during his reign. He had the Joysagar tank, the biggest of its kind in Assam, excavated at Rangpur. A temple called Joydol was built by its side, and another temple was built at Ranganath. Roads along Khorikotia, Duborizan, and Meteka, and masonry bridges over the Namdang and Dimor rivers were other famous accomplishments of Rudra Singha. Achievements of Rudra Singha in the field of culture. Rudra Singha created a special officer called Boiragi to visit different places and report him about the socio-cultural life led in those places. Rudra Singha appointed officers like Gayan Borwa to patronize local art and culture. Rudra Singha created officers like Henswa Borwa and Kukuraswa Borwa to promote sports. This Ahom monarch had the Bihu celebrated in the palace courtyard for 7 days. Rudra Singha was also a patron of learning. Kobiraj Chakravarti composed the famous drama Hankachurabad and translated the Abhijnanam Sakuntalam and Brahmavarta Purana into Assamese. Rudra Singha finished the survey of Sipsagar. Rudra Singha sent boys to Bengal and Bihar to study at the centers of learning. Rudra Singha sent men to Delhi to learn Mughal music. Mughal dress was introduced in the Ahom court during the reign of Rudra Singha. Rudra Singha was a visionary ruler. He departed from the traditional policy of isolation and tried to have friendship with some contemporary Indian rulers. He appreciated the value of cultural assimilation. It was likely that he wanted to forge a cultural contact with India. We can have an overall estimate of Rudra Singha. Rudra Singha was by no means a mere military adventurer. He possessed of a retentive memory and exceptional intelligence and power of initiative. His reign is remembered as the epitome of the Ahom power and glory. He may rightly be called as the greatest Ahom monarch. The sources in preparing this lecture have been Gunabhiram Borwa, Ahom Buronji, H.K. Borpuzari edited The Comprehensive History of Assam, S.L. Borwa, A Comprehensive History of Assam, Lakshmi Devi, Ahom Tribal Relations, Sir Edward Gate, A History of Assam, Padmanath Gohai Borwa, Ahomor Buronji.